anterior cruciate ligament, or ACL, is the most commonly injured ligament of the knee. It's one of four stabilizing ligaments of your knee. You ready for this? There's the PCL, posterior cruciate ligament, the MCL, the medial collateral ligament, and the LCL, the lateral collateral ligament, in addition to this ACL, the anterior cruciate ligament. Your ACL is located in the center of your knee and runs from the back of your femur or thigh bone to the front of your tibia or shin bone. Your cruciate ligaments cross like an X. That's why we call them cruciates. And they're in the center of your knee. These cruciates, the ACL and the PCL, are responsible for limiting the front-back movement as well as rotation of your knee. Those collateral ligaments, the MCL and the LCL, they limit side-to-side movement. You depend on that ACL to walk, run, but especially to jump, twist, and pivot. ACL tears, anterior cruciate ligament tears, can occur by themselves. We call these isolated tears, but frequently they can occur with some other injuries, such as injuries of the MCL or the LCL or the meniscus. Let's look at the front view of the right knee. First of all, the thigh bone called the femur that sits on top of the leg bone called the tibia. We have the two meniscus or shock absorbers between the bones. Then we have a series of ropes or ligaments that connect the outsides of this knee. The ligament on this side, or the outer side, is called the lateral collateral ligament, the LCL. And then its partner on the inner side here, that again starts on this shelf, but now attaches more broadly along this inner side of the leg bone, and this is called the MCL. We have two ligaments that cross in the middle of the knee. These are called the cruciate ligaments because they cross. We have first the anterior cruciate ligament that runs in this direction, the ACL, and then running behind it, its partner, the posterior cruciate, PCL. Superimposed over the front, we can draw the kneecap or patella. Now, if we draw a side view of this knee, it looks something like this. Here's the thigh bone or the femur. Here is the meniscus attached to the leg bone. If we look in profile at the kneecap, it looks something like this. Then the kneecap is attached to the leg bone by the patella tendon. And then we have another tendon here, the quadriceps tendon, that attaches the thigh muscle called the quadriceps that pulls in this direction. If we looked at a cross section through the middle of this knee, in other words, this were the cross section, in the middle of the knee, the anterior cruciate ligament attaches up here on the thigh bone and down here on the leg bone. So we have what is really a check rein type of ligament or rope. And this rope prevents this bone, the leg bone, from translating forward because it's hooked up from here to here. So it prevents this motion. What happens when you tear your anterior cruciate ligament? Well, most of the time you tear it right through the middle here, which is right through the middle here. And when that happens, you now have the ability of this leg bone to move forward, and you have an unstable or loose knee. When that happens, it needs to be fixed. ACL tears are most commonly caused by sports-related injuries. However, anyone who has one of these mechanisms of injury can tear their ACL. Some common causes or mechanisms include a sudden deceleration, like when you stop or slow down quickly, a hyperextension of the knee, or a sudden pivot or change of direction, like if you step in a hole in your yard. Studies show that women, however, are 2 to 4 times more likely to tear their ACL than men. Why? Well, this is probably due to a number of factors. First of all, women often have a strength imbalance between the muscles in the front of their thigh, their quadriceps, and the muscles in the back of their thigh, the hamstrings. More women than ever are competing in athletics, and as such, the number of injuries has increased. Poor body mechanics, however, during jumping, landing, cutting, or pivoting can also attribute to the increased number of ACLs in women. Finally, ladies tend to have looser, more flexible joints than men, making them more prone to these ACL tears.